Nyepi. Ruthie Joy and Ellen and I are in the kitchen, and there's a lot of magical things occurring. And so we were going over what occurred last night in the transmissions in the field, and some of them that we didn't post. The ones that we spoke about later when Ellen and Unity were decoding the field and navigating the golden pot. And of course, we're on the full moon, 0 degrees Virgo, ruled by Mercury, the messenger, blah, blah, blah. We were just breaking down some understanding for and with Ruthie, who's joined us in the kitchen, of what the guidance showed was occurring in the field. And there was, a very intense period in the, and yes, I'm just going to use these words, in the transmission last night, one of the ones we haven't posted, where what was coming through the guidance was tracking the entity of longing in the field and looking directly at you, at Ruthie, and saying, you get on a plane, go home, get out of here, you're not welcome. And the transmission was so full on in my own perspective as being a vessel of the transmission, and just completely humbling myself and stepping back to allow it to come through, and holding the field with Ruthie, and Ruthie going through her own emotional process in the release of the being. And from being a vessel of the transmissions, one thing I learned for sure in walking into the center of some of the quotation marks off-world dark masculine on Earth, I really learned and discovered the power of the transmission and witnessed it transform the field, especially when I went to Florida to be in the house for a week with members of the cabal in January of 2016. And when I walked through the front door feeling the transmission come through and going, oh my God, to like literally feel the power of creation going, all right. And how I had been shown I was being sent to present the invitation, the truce knot, to the off-world energies on the earth before I was sent there. When I went into a prayer before going surfing in Kauai with Machui, I did my surfing prayer and said, oh my God, to Machui, they just showed me a vision, and I think I'm about to be sent into the center of the cabal and off-world energies on the earth to deliver them a message, the truce knot, to tell them it's a game over on the earth. And that's what I said to Machu before we went surfing. And when I came out, that's when I was on the call with Steve saying the councils are being set up and you need to come now to Florida. So that's what was coming through last night in the field, speaking to the sentient being of longing. And what I just shared with Ruthie Joy and Elowon is that in 2015, when we did the trip, the first trip to Egypt between the solar and the blood moon lunar eclipse, the guidance said we were being cocooned to bring the codes in for the 144,000 ascended masters to embody on the earth before the end of August 2015. And Freedom and I, now that I think of it, met the night before August 31st, or maybe two nights before. We probably met on August 29th, yes, okay. Because that's when my friend's son said he wanted more of the community in Kauai to know who I was and what I was bringing. So he created a gathering, and maybe 30 people had come to one of the community homes, and a transmission came through. And that was the morning when, before we gathered in the evening, I said to the guidance, what am I speaking of? What am I sharing? And that's when the guidance had me open the keys of Enoch to key 110 about the languages of light. And that's where I read the original root languages on the planet were Chinese, Tibetan, Hebrew, Egyptian, and Sanskrit. And that when two were spoken simultaneous, I can't remember which two, they worked on the horizontal grids of the body. When two were spoken simultaneous, they worked on the vertical grids of the body. And when all five were spoken together with Hebrew, and the guidance came in and went, and this is your light language, it said, it causes the overdoming of the Christed over self over the physical flesh suit, which then accelerates the ascension process. And so in 2014, many people had said, hey, do you want to speak light language? And I continually said, no, the guidance is telling me I'm not allowed to speak my light language in this planetary system yet. And it was when I was given the White Queen crystal skull and the Hopi corn to take South America a few days, Miracle Day coordinates later, that the light language began to come in. And the guidance explained that I wasn't allowed to speak my light language on the earth until then because it would have fried out people's circuitry. So, in the gathering on the 29th of August, where Freedom and I first met, a transmission came through that night in light language, and it was that the guidance said the Magdalenes had gathered. And so this full transmission in light language came through. I didn't start off speaking in English with the group. And when I was watching the codes come in, it was a very profound transmission. So Freedom and Lukaija met or came together that night in recognition of each other. And then Freedom went home and said her body burned for 16 hours. And I was staying with our mutual friend Elsa at 22.2222 degrees north latitude in her little canoe cottage in the north end of Kauai. And Elsa told me in the morning that her friend at the time had a different name, but we'll refer to her Freedom as Freedom, that her friend Freedom had called and said, oh my gosh, who is this woman my body burned for so long? So on the night of August 30th, I met Jesse and Kaimi, who were builders of the final canoe, the 14th canoe of the prophecies of the root races on the earth. And I met with them on the navigational heiau, which they call a warrior's heiau. It's really a navigational heiau. And we did a ceremony together. We did prayers and blessings to receive guidance and coordinates. And we actually have an amazing photo from there, because when we went to the place that they said they had found the sacred stone on the top of the pyramid, because the heiau was actually underneath all of the jungle and the grass, and they had been clearing it to maintain their birthrights for spiritual purposes, to protect this land, which was all being developed by rich people, so to speak. So they had started clearing the land there, and that halted the progress of development. And so when we sat on the side of the hill, Kaimi said, we're sitting on a pyramid, and all the elders tell us that there's canoes inside this pyramid. And then he pointed out to the valley of Hanalei and pointed out the Stargate portals. This one's for the Pleiades, this one is for Andromeda, and so on and so on. And than when we went up to the sacred stone that they had uncovered and they stood together on it, and I took a picture. This spear of light came through the sky like a pillar, and it's captured in the photo. And we all went, wow, what was that?
Wow.
So that night I slept in my rental van, and then in the morning said, the guidance woke me up and said, go to Polihale. And Polihale is said to have been the outgoing portal for spirits on the planet, the incoming portal being the birthing heiau or the anahola heiau. Tell you, these lights in this kitchen. Lights in the kitchen just dimmed. Seems to be happening a lot in the miracle coordinate in our sentient living library monastery house. So yes, Polihale was said to be the outgoing portal. The lights are dimming again. This is quite profound. The lights just went completely out in the kitchen. How interesting. We love this sentient house. You know, the Hopi prophecy said the lights would go out.
Well,
I remember little grandmother long miracles ago when I first saw her, and she had talked about when the lights go out for 3 days to prepare ourselves to play games and keep the vibration high. And in the kitchen, the lights keep going out. This sentient house. So, Polihale was said to have the outgoing portal for souls on the planet. And that morning when I woke, the guidance said, go into Polihale now. So I drove there, and on my way, Freedom called me, and it was really the first communique we had had since we had met a few Miracle Coordinates nights before, and we really hadn't spoken much, and Elsa had passed on my number, so Freedom called, and we spoke most of the drive from the north side of the island to Polihale. And when I got there, I said, the guidance said for me to do ceremony at the military gates, because on this part of the island, there was said to be many military installations in the mountains of Kauai, and according to Thoth, in the Flower of Life books that he wrote and the Rainbow Serpent of Light, he said there is a massive crystal off the north shore of Kauai that is older than Thoth could proclaim its whereabouts. So our friend Terry Lilly, who has worked for many years to protect the marine life and the cetaceans and such, is part of a family on the earth. And of course, this is all past history, yet we're just sharing these pieces because it's all in the miracle coordinate. It's all being blessed through the love coordinate, the miracle of the golden pot. So Terry Lilly lived in a trailer at Honolulu Bay, and he would swim and snorkel and scuba dive every day and make videos of the marine life in Honolulu Bay and give them for free to schools, for school children to see all the beautiful marine life. Mm-hmm. And he made these great videos and beautiful photographs, and just so amazing. And so Terry is about, I don't know how tall is Mr. Lilly. He's good tall one, I'd say maybe 6'7", 6'8". The guidance is saying he's shrunk a little now with all of his surfing injuries. So his family, super Palladian, his uncle in the Guinness World Book of Records is the tallest man. One of his brothers was the head of bioengineering, which is GMO. Mm. And his other brother was the head of the Nyepi, U.S. Navy general. So he says the only reason that he's still alive for all of his outspoken speaking upon what was happening on Kauai was because of who his brothers were. And so his brothers confirmed many things, which is like all of the Stargate portals that were being used on the island of Kauai. And there was 13 microwave cell towers installed on the ridge that sat above Polihale. And Terry Lilly, who had been documenting the marine life in all over the world, and particularly in Hanalei Bay for years, went swimming one morning to discover that one third of the coral reef was dead in a miracle coordinate day. And so he was very persistent to understand why, and through his long deductions, he discovered that's when the microwave cell towers turned on. And this was all part of nuclear war games, space wars, CERN, HARP, and so much more. And so the cetaceans stopped coming to the north shore of Kauai. And Om and I went out with Terry many times in the Zodiac, and miracle things came. And back to Polihale, the outgoing portal for the souls on the planet. So while Freedom and I were getting to remember each other on the earth plane through the call, I said, I'm here now at the military gates, and one of the processes I did on the earth was return my womb blood to the earth in all of my ceremonies, along with the sacred water that I carried and moved around the earth from place to place. And so, of course, as we've shared many times before, the prophecy of the indigenous said, when the women of the earth return their blood to the earth, the men will come home from the war. And so that was part of the ceremonies. And when I convened with the 13 grandmothers, I learned to understand more about what we were doing. And certainly in my grid work on the earth, I discovered the power of the womb and the womb blood when I traveled and was joined by a group of dowsers who would, in England in 2014, would come with me on my grid work, and I would say, okay, a ceremony here, and they would douse the area, and there was no geometries, and then I would put down the womb blood and the sacred water and do a prayer, and they would consistently douse 12 petaled flowers that were 2 to 3 meters long with a second layer of petals. And if we weren't going off the edge of the cliff, they would always measure, they would detect a third layer of petals going out. That's the power of the womb, the sacred blood of the human, and to create form. And it is said that the Magdalene star seeds had a cosmic womb. So anything that went through into the Magdalenes was restored to source code. So when Freedom and I were on the phone, I went to the military gates and began to do water blessings with her on the phone with me, and spray my womb blood on the cameras that were at the gates of the military installments. And then I went to the entrance of Polihale, and it's a 2-mile drive in, and the gate was locked. And it was a time when there was supposed to be 3 Class 4 hurricanes coming to the island. And Tanya and I had been together on Big Island swimming with the dolphins for 3 weeks, receiving the assistance of Transfiguration. And then the guidance came in and said, go to Kauai now. I posted on Facebook I was on my way, and that's when my friend's son wrote to me and said, did you know that we have 3 Class 4 hurricanes on the way? So The first one was averted the night that I arrived, and the second one was supposed to be coming in when I walked into Polihale. So the gate was locked, and the guidance said, wait here for the appropriate time coordinate, of which I did. I sat in my van in the back with the door open, playing my guitar for about 2 miracle hour coordinates, and then all of a sudden the guidance said, start walking in. And it was later in the afternoon, and so I began walking in, and as I did, I came across some workers who were repairing a little part of the road, nothing major, not like cars couldn't get in. And I was walking in my bikini and bare feet with long blonde hair, 6'3". And all of the workers were like, what's it doing? What's up? I said, I'm going to do ceremony with the earth to avert the hurricane. Nice. And they said, have a nice day. So I kept going, and then the second mile in, the guidance said to call Tanya, and Tanya and I spoke, and I think, weren't you and Tanya like texting at the time or something?
Yeah, yes, we were in North Dakota. When did we run that time?
You were still in North Dakota. Mm-hmm. Okay, interesting. So, the guidance said to call Tanya, so I spoke with Tanya the second mile of the walk in, and as soon as Tanya and I got on the phone, an owl flew out of the forest, and it was still daytime. Mm-hmm. And it dropped 2 feathers, 1 black, 1 white, and went down the center of the road about 2 feet off the road, straight ahead. And then the entire walk, it would fly back and forth. It would go back into the forest, and then it would come across the road, and it would fly over the GMO fields towards the military installments in the mountains, and then fly back towards me and into the forest and come out again and go straight down the middle of the road 2 feet again. It was such a profound miracle and blessing. Mm-hmm. And so I had been listening to Nacho Bear, and at the time that I spoke to Tanya, and I believe she called in, it stopped the music that was playing.
Said to honor, I'll take away my shields. You are loud and reckless.
So that I had been listening to as I was walking in when Tanya called. And as I stepped out onto... All right, we'll keep playing. Sorry, team. Pain to some good use anyway. That's kind of like what we're teaching in the chat, yeah? And so there was a lot of miracles occurring for the consciousness, keeping in mind, although I hadn't noted this in my head again, this was the day that basically a year before had come through the coordinates after finishing the 5-month walkabout on the grids, when back in the lands of Albion, Washune, the guidance came in and said, take the people to Egypt between these dates to bring in the codes for the 144,000 ascended masters to embody on the planet before the end of August 2015. And little did I realize that day was that day.
Oh my gosh.
So the owl led the way and it dropped a black and a white feather. And I was listening to these amazing lyrics of Nacobert. And it had just finished saying, put that pain to some good use anyway, when Tanya called. And so then our call completed. And we walked out onto the beautiful beach of Polihale. And as the phone hung up and I saw the massive nature of what was here, these words played. This turned on. I'm powerful. I'm powerful and I'm not afraid no more. I will do things I've never done before because I'm powerful and I'm not afraid no more. The embodiment of the teachings, to role model the journey for the family, for liberation upon the earth. And so those lyrics played and Nako was with me, Sandalfizi, and Nako. And I stepped out onto the beach where this giant outgoing portal for the human consciousness was. And I stepped on a shell of a bullet. And the guidance had me create a massive mandala in the center of the beach and to do the water blessing and to place the blood on the earth. And I knew this was a huge miracle coordinate for humanity. Because the field was wide open. And only days before I had returned to the kahuna at the birthing Heiau. The one who had sent us with the crystal orbs to the pyramids in Egypt to place in the grids in 2015 to clear the entities off of the earth. We didn't talk about it in that way when we placed them, of course. I had been to see him a few days before. I had gone at nighttime and arrived at his little shacky lean-to, barely a roof, protecting the birthing Heiau where the dolphins and whales come in. Where Om and I had gone to meet with him before we went to Egypt. Many people that winter, after bringing Atulashima, the white queen crystal skull, home to Kauai, the one who reincarnated as Mary Magdalene and left her crystal skull in the grids to quiet guide humanity home to the true coordinates, Lemuria, the Lemurian consciousness that had been raped and distorted when the tear occurred in the space-time continuum upon the earth. So Om and I went to see the kahuna at the beginning of March before we left for Egypt, and Om had no money, and I had said I was not paying for him to come to Egypt. And so we went at sunrise, and a young woman took us to meet the kahuna, and we walked in and sat with him, and he basically ignored me and made chit-chat with Om, asked him all kinds of questions, and discovered that Om lived on Vancouver Island in the grids of Albion, but no one used those words. And the kahuna said that his son also lived on Vancouver Island. And while he made nice chit-chat with Om, and later the young woman said to us, "Wow, I've never seen him connect with a man like that before." The kahuna all of a sudden said with a loud roar to Om, "She's not yelling at you, she's trying to teach you. Sit down, shut the fuck up, and listen." And then he looked at me and rolled up his sleeve and slapped his shoulder and said, "Whale Clan," as he placed his hand on the tattoo of his shoulder. And I started to cry. And then he told the young woman to take me up into the Heiau. And as I stood up, he said, "Miss Crybaby over here, we don't even need to talk because we're already communicating. And she knows we're almost completed." So I had gone back to meet the kahuna months later after Egypt. And Om ended up coming with us because days after visiting the Heiau at the beginning of March, as I was taken up into it, and men were not welcome in it because the kahuna said it was a birthing portal and only for the feminine. And he told me to go up there and lean back on a rock and receive the Pleiadian coordinates. And so the young woman took me up, and there was three sacred crystal orbs, quite large. You had to hold them with both hands. Quartz crystal, and she invited me to place my hands on each one and connect with it through my first eye. and receive coordinates, and so I did. And the largest one was quite large. It was like the size of a human brain. And so we left that day, and when we got up from sitting with the kahuna, he looked at Om and told him to come back alone. And just before we left Kauai, when Om had no money and I said I wasn't paying for him to come to Egypt, one day he said, I have to show you something. And he opened his bag and he had the three sacred orbs from the birthing Heiau, where the dolphins and the whales come into the earth plane according to the legends of the kahunas. Stargates. And of course, Kauai is where I had my remembrance long before I knew this, of coming to the earth as a dolphin in my first incarnation to help Gaia through her ascension process. And so Om pulled the three sacred crystal orbs from his bag, and I was very in surprise. And he said, the kahuna says, I have to go with you to Egypt, that your work on the planet is very important, and that I am to protect you and make sure that these get placed into the grids. So Mr. Om came with us to Kauai, and Germay had asked, or to Egypt. And Mr. Germay had asked recently who we were with in Egypt in 2015. So Elawan was there, and Tanya was there, and Shulay and Omar and Om and David and others were with us to receive the coordinates for the 144,000 ascended masters to come in as we were being cocooned in the grids of Egypt. So when I returned to Kauai, when the guidance called me there after swimming with the dolphins on Big Island for 3 weeks, going through transfiguration on behalf of the collective in a very transpersonal way, swimming out to be with the dolphins every day and crying, and the dolphins explaining that my heart field was opening up massive and absorbing the mind of the collective pain body. That's called crucifixion for the collective, to feel the pain of everyone. And beautiful Tanya Kwan, our Mother Mary from Hummingbird Ranch, was there to hold me through the process. So when I returned to Kauai and went to sit with the kahuna, when I arrived at night, and he said he had been praying all day to have the one sent to him who could take this all the way through with him. And here we are in the grids of Albion, where he told me that he and the Queen had signing authority for all of the assets of the earth people. So days later, there I was walking out onto the beach in Polihale with Nako Bear singing. I will do things I have never done before and let these lyrics resonate through the bodies and beings of each one of us. In our transfiguration process, and let us say it is complete and over and done, and that we are having fun. I will do things I have never done before because I'm powerful and I'm not afraid. No more. And so on August 31st, 2015, after spraying my blood all over the video cameras of the military that had the beautiful island of Lemuria under siege, harnessing the Earth's Kundalini. I stood in the middle of the massive mandala I made on the beach. There was not a single person there that day. And the gate was locked. Class 4 hurricane was on its way. And I put the casing of the bullet in the center of the ceremony with the white and the black feather. And the womb blood that came through me and the sacred waters from the long journey of love and Unio Mystica upon the earth. And then an incredible prayer came through me, and I said, you send me a clear and cosmic signal that this is real and this is happening and that we are truly making a difference with this journey. And all of a sudden the energy of the cosmic mother came through. I was on the earth and it had me leap up, and this yelp came through and my head was thrown back, and it was the exaltation of the cosmic mother. And what the guidance showed in the miracle coordinate was that men upon the earth had been released from captivity of war that had formed itself into a sentient being and had chosen the masculine energy on the earth of the sons and the fathers and the brothers to be its own personal lover. And as my head exalted back, I looked up on the ridge and saw the 13 microwave cell towers and went, fuck, I get it. So these structures that were created on the earth, like CERN and HOP, etc., were programmed to influence the masculine alpha consciousness on the earth to kill, to destroy, to satiate a program, an entity, a being. And because it was the outgoing portal for the souls on the earth, what the guidance showed was that humanity was not ascending, because the feminine was remaining behind in her own turmoil and pain and wounding at the loss of her beloved divine masculine to an entity called war. And so it showed that both the masculine and feminine energies had been pinned to the earth through the artificial grids to AI, to war games. And that is why humanity was not ascending out of the outgoing portal for souls on the earth. And it showed that because the feminine would not rise up, because she was holding on to the wounded masculine that was being held down by an entity named war, the miracle that the liberation came in the ceremony, and I exalted up. I was shown all of this, and the feminine energy was released, and so was the masculine. And there was a massive wave of consciousness of aeons of times of souls that had been locked and recycled, and the guidance showed that they were coming directly back in through the incoming portal on the other side of the island that the kahuna Ed sat upon. And the reason Ed was praying for assistance and comes across as kind of a crazy guy and unpredictable is because Ed sat on that heiau day and night, transfiguring and transmuting the distortion. Hence why he was calling for assistance. And as the exalted cosmic mother came through, and this yelp and cry came through my being, and tears flowing down my face, streaking the sand and the bullet and the feathers and the blood in the water in the center of the massive mandala, I looked up and there was the most incredible double rainbow that touched on both sides of the mandala. I had pictures on the hard drive that was stolen in Costa Rica. And it was confirmation that the gateway was opened and the souls on the earth plane would be and were being liberated. Because the recycling process that was created by AI made it impossible to graduate from the earth. And so, as the sun went down and I began the barefoot walk out on the muddy road, and the sun went down, and I walked along, a man came up behind me out of nowhere, felt like Gandalf, and he walked with me most of the road. Mystical star being, and he talked about the star maps all the way, and he asked if he might get a ride into town, and I said I was guided to sleep at the gates of the military establishment, and he said no problem, he would walk. So I climbed into my van, and every night on the islands I always slept with the doors wide open and never locked anything. And that night, the guidance said, close all of it and lock the doors. And as I lay down and began to rest, all of the locks in the van began to sound like something was trying to open them. And it happened all night long. And the guidance said, you are love. So no need for protection. And the next morning, I got in the van and drove to be with Miss Freedom. And it was the first time we really got to drop in on this earthly planet. And that journey was the day that the guidance said our whole trip to Egypt in 2015 would be the coordinate for the 144,000 ascended masters to embody on the earth. So what stimulated the sharing was that Ruthie and Alawan, when I shared the piece about the entity of war, both felt very strong the realization of what morphogenic fields become when we empower them. They become sentient beings. and they have their own emotions and feelings. And so just like war and just like anger, with longing or desire or joy or aggression, whatever, this is why we learn to perfect ourselves in the presence of these sentient other selves. And we become the captain of our ship. And we choose who's steering and driving it. And the intensity of the transmission last night coming through, speaking to longing and speaking to, what was the word you used last night, Ruthie?
Yearning.
Yearning, yes. And it was speaking to the longing in the field, the sentient being, with assertion of the authority of the oracle, which just so happens to have the true alpha gene, not the alpha distortion that serves itself, but the alpha of creation that restores balance and benevolence for all. Equal. And that's what was asserting its authority upon the field in the miracle coordinate of last night for all of life. And any aspect of us that are harboring it, to say, longing and yearning, in a shadow frequency, you're out the door, and that's what happened. And now our pod is coming into a whole new level of realization, understanding, and coordinates. And Gear May yesterday was guided to purchase the domain name unitycodes.love, because as he and we, the pod, and all of the collective are navigating we energy, Gear May said he's beginning to see that now the mission is to catalog it, all of the transmissions and the codes, and he gets the living library piece. And what we have been doing and what we continue to serve the Earth Collective and the Cosmic, which is exactly what the guidance said the living library would be, to restore the pillars to the cosmic Akash, to put out the cookie crumbs again so that spirit can effortlessly move in and out of the realms of the physical creation. This is who we are and what we are, quotation marks, doing. And simultaneous, we are experiencing it. Because we are doing things we may not remember we have done before. And we are powerful. And we are not afraid no more. God bless Knuckle Bear.
Nice. Introduce.
Introducing the Nissan Kicks with immersive
headrest speakers. Introducing Nissan Kicks. So skipping the ad and it's just doing one more. Wrong song. It's not wrong. It's just we're going to do Nyepi one more time.
Please.
dying spirit anyways.
This is real love. This is real intimacy. And this is our birthright as sovereign beings of creation. Together. We stand together. For all life. Together.